If you are watching this to find out how James Hobart did in the 2014 Northeast Regional, this feature probably isn't for you. He placed second. I hope I didn't ruin the ending. My name is Torin Simpson, and I was given the assignment of documenting James's regional experience. I didn't know him very well before this project, but after 5 days of sleeping on his couch and invading every aspect of his personal life, I learned that there's a lot more to James Hobart than the competitor you will see at the CrossFit Games. In fact, competition is perhaps the least important aspect of his life. So let's start at the beginning, in the small town of Otis, in Berkshire County, Massachusetts.
The Berkshires are a wonderful place to raise a child because it's a small community and you know everybody. You don't lock your door, you don't lock your car. This is just a wonderful place to live. It really is.
Growing up, I was really lucky because I had a lot of family around, so I'm an only child. But, I was always around other people and tons of areas to like run around and play, and you're constantly immersed in nature and wildlife and all that stuff, so I loved it.
He really always loved being outside. I can honestly say that. The minute he could walk, that's where he was. He's always been outside, so.
When you're a little kid, everything, like, I just remember everything here always being so big. And then, like, I don't come home super often, like, probably once every 2 months. And it's like, every time I come back home, I'm like, wow, this place is so tiny. It was just crazy to see. This is how you know your mom is cool. And you walk in, there's an axle bar next to all of the cleaning products. That's for real. Well, how would I describe our relationship?
I don't know. How would you?
Mama's boy.
Super. He's not a mama's boy.
Really close.
Who called you that?
Right, get out of the shot.
You want me to punch him out? I'll take him down.
We're trying to have an interview. I'm very, very close to my mom. After my parents were divorced, I lived with my mom, and at first that was a nightmare, because when you're a teenage boy, and you live with your mom, you just, she's like the last person in the world you want to deal with. But luckily I think we have a really awesome, strong relationship, and she's really supportive and proud of me, and I'm hopefully supportive. I'm absolutely proud of her, especially with regards to CrossFit and just all the steps she's taken to take care of herself. So we're really close. Yeah, really close. So my mom went to her level one. So this was my mom's coaching strategy. Frank, she's partnered up with like...
Jeremy. Name was Jeremy.
Whatever.
He's my partner.
Jeremy. The biggest, burliest, like manliest dude in the room. And this was my mom's coaching strategy. She'd watch him do a rep and then she'd be like, come on, Jeremy. That was it. It was just the strike and clap was the, that was no cues, no chest up.
That was not true. That was not true. Austin was there. I was telling him to put his shoulders on. I said, shoulders to the floor.
That was good. Range of motion. That was it. Just put your back to the ground in the sit up. So. My mom's not super athletic. I hope she can't hear me say that. And she was smoking and I think just from me being so immersed in the community and her surveying it from the outside, I think slowly she was just getting more involved in it. She was just always great supporting me. Like, she'd always come to competitions and ask me about it.
As he got more involved in CrossFit, I watched more and more CrossFit on the internet. So I quit smoking, and that in that process of quitting smoking, I mean, you have to replace the bad habit with something else. So it was the opportunity to replace it with CrossFit. And CrossFit has been a big positive influence in me working through quitting smoking. Because, at least a day at a time, I can always make this choice. Am I going to smoke or am I going to do CrossFit? And CrossFit wins out. So I'm very grateful for that.
She just... totally got involved into it like most people do. Like when she started, couldn't get enough of it. And now, it's to the point where on the weekends when the regionals are going on, she's like sending me statistics of other athletes and giving me advice on movements I should practice after surveying my open performance. And You know, and I said a while ago, I said, you know, no matter what happens this year from a competitive standpoint, I couldn't ask for anything more inside of CrossFit because it's, you know, I get to see all the health benefits and community benefits that I got from it. You know, now she has, and it's cool to see your closest family members have that. I just got to CrossFit New England. I'm gonna do some warm-up stuff, and come on, let's go.
Now that we've set up the James Hobart backstory, let's fast forward a bit. This is CrossFit New England. After individual appearances at the CrossFit Games in 2009 and 2010, James decided to go team. And since then, a majority of his training has taken place here.
3, 2, 1, go! Let's go, guys, get after 8:30.
He's the type of guy that when others are around him, they raise their standards. And we actually had a team dinner last night with our team. This is the first year he hasn't been on our team in a while. And that came up about James, is that he's the type of athlete and type of person that when you're training with him, when you're with him, you become a better person. You want to work harder. You do more work than you would before. You perform better. And he brings out the best in people. So
the community piece at CrossFit New England is very similar to, and just like the awesome community piece at all the CrossFit gyms that I think people talk about and love. For me, it's just the individuals there. The people I get along with, the friends. It's an easy place to work hard, but not take yourself too seriously.
Is this music too serious? Do you ever notice that fit people rarely wear shirts? Sorry, I'm getting sidetracked here. Don't take yourself too seriously. Sound advice. Wait a minute. Rewind. Does James have a black eye? We'll get to that later. Now, you really can't talk about James Hobart without talking about this guy. 4-time CrossFit Games competitor, Austin Maliolo.
You're like one of those like Lego cartoons. You're like, da-da-da-da, and then like you do your thing, you're like, da-da-da-da, and like you do something else, and then like you're the guy, like this is you. You text me, I call you, you don't pick up. It pisses me off.
Because you take for you, like, listen, talking to you on the phone. Austin is the guy that's like, we at the end of the conversation? Yeah, okay. Oh, wait, one more thing.
Yeah.
Oh, how is your day going? How is your day? Austin,
no,
I have to go. Austin,
James.
I have to go. Oh, wait, one more thing. Like, what color shoes are you wearing?
I like to communicate.
I know, you do.
I hate texting. Texting's dangerous. Emotion doesn't get transferred in texting.
They're like BFFs.
Every time James is here, they'll FaceTime pretty regularly. It's kind of creepy. So maybe creepy is the way I would, no, I'm just kidding.
They're best friends. James was the best man at his wedding, so they're one and the same.
Yeah, super close, sort of like an old married couple, but that's sort of like brothers, you know what I mean? Like brothers that grew up super close in age, always kind of at each other's throats, but really love each other.
Yeah, very similar to that, because they gripe at each other and like, you know, they'll get their feelings hurt when the other one does something. Yeah, very. Old married couple would be definitely a good explanation for their relationship.
What are you munching on?
Just some peanut butter.
Skippy. Second ingredient, sugar.
Actually, correct.
Yep, I know.
Third ingredient, hydrogenated vegetable oil.
Oh, my bad.
All right. All right, so I'll get there at 9-ish. I'll see you at the gym.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Oh. Hey, Dave. Your own private little good to see VIP you. Training area.
Hey, Justin. Good to see you, man.
Have a fun weekend.
Thank you.
What's wrong with your voice?
I got sick at the beginning of the month. And it hasn't come back.
He's just trying to be like Frony. Yeah.
No, he got me sick, so I blame him for that.
Wait, why does James get a special visit from the director of the CrossFit Games on day one of the Northeast Regional? We'll get to that in 1 second. Actually, somebody give me a music track. Perfect, that'll work. And let's just go ahead and cue the gratuitous fitness montage.
That's it for me, you know, as being a coach, being a trainer, on seminar staff is really one of the best things that's happened to me inside of CrossFit, and probably the thing I'm most proud of, and it is my job.
So if you're on the L1 seminar staff, that makes Dave Castro your boss. And it's Castro, in the role of director of training, that ultimately decides if you have what it takes to be a Flowmaster.
I think there's just a lot of respect for the position because of sort of the gravity that every weekend you have to run this show and you have to let people know about what CrossFit is, and you're showing them that you want them to have that same experience that you had. And like I said, ultimately that responsibility ends with you.
I'm so honored to be included in the 30 people who have that title, and to be even considered for the position was absolutely amazing. The biggest vantage point being a Flowmaster, I think, gives me is being able to see and learn even more from everybody else. Because you get to see them in sometimes more of a role of evaluation.
James, he's got a law degree. He's a Flowmaster for level one. He's a pretty sharp dude. So, I mean, he can do really whatever he wants.
It was really cool watching you guys do your thing side by side. It was pretty cool.
Man, it was getting the shit out of people's hands.
This hand.
You okay?
Yeah.
I see that. You fell on your face. Really?
Yeah, I've never had that.
You know why?
Trying hard, bro.
I fell on the handstand walk. I can. Trying to get those last couple of little steps. Austin punched me. No, I'm just kidding. I fought the judge. No, I literally fell on my face on my last step on my hands. No carrying. Gotta get those extra inches.
He does shit like this because he got a little confidence because he walks further than he thought he would. And he's like, you know, I want more attention. I already got a video crew following me, so I want every little bitty to feel sorry for me. See? Look at him. He knows it too. Solid. Look at him.
Oh my God.
I just think it's karma. It's karma for me telling you about the Dubai thing.
Yeah. Hey, I'm pissed that I didn't beat you more in that event.
That's great.
Sorry.
What's up?
What's going on in here?
I'm watching videos and reading articles about graphene.
Graphene?
Yep.
What is that?
It's basically one layer of graphite, and it's supposed to be some super material.
Huh. How's your eyeball?
It feels good. It's a little black and blue.
How many people have been asking you about your eye?
The count is up to 22. People have asked me that.
Yeah, look at your eyes, looking beastly. Check my hand out. It doesn't hurt to the touch anymore.
That's good. Well, it looks like it's healed up a lot.
Yeah, so I put some stuff on it. I wrote some. What was that?
Torin's computer.
Oh, I thought someone like hacked into our FaceTime.
Meh. Bang.
You naked?
Close.
That was on camera.
Yeah. I mean, I could get naked. I have no issues being naked.
And that, I know. You know what Torin asked me today?
What?
He said, would you go back in time and win the handstand walk, but in order to do so, you'd have to break your nose?
The answer is yes.
I said no.
Really?
It's only one point.
I would break every non-vital bone in my body to win any event.
But what if it affected the way you compete in the rest of the weekend?
No, that's non-vital. So okay. Like I would rip an ear off. I would rip an eyelid off.
I
would like looking down.
I said I would break my nose to get higher up in the snatch event.
I would rip my whole bottom lip off to make my final lift.
Oh God! Oh, there you go.
Deal with the repercussions later.
There you have it. That's the go-getter attitude you want, Torin. No lip malleolo.
Malolio. No, how'd that happen?
Malolio. Here comes
lip.
No lip malolio.
Your eye.
I fell on it yesterday.
Yeah, but when?
That's another person. Doing a handstand walk.
You did? Yeah, when you came
down? You want to give it a kiss?
Yeah.
Maybe Austin was right. James is really playing up the whole black eye incident.
You get emails, you know, from people that, hey, I was at your seminar in Lexington, Kentucky. Good luck this weekend. Or you know, you'll see little flashes on social media. Someone will say, hey, rooting for my level one coach. And man, it's you know, I think if I go out there and didn't finish well, I think they're still happy and proud and supportive. But deep down inside, I'm like, shit, I let those guys down. So personally, yeah, for me, there's a lot of self-imposed stress there.
James Hobart's biggest weakness in CrossFit is probably his negative self-talk.
And in second place from CrossFit New England, James Hobart.
Yeah!
Under 30 seconds, athletes, hands on your lane marker.
It's in his personality that he likes to set goals for himself, and he likes to achieve his goals. That's just who he is as a person in any area of his life. So I think that if there's pressure, it's his own pressure that he's putting on himself. Go, James! Yeah!
Way to go, James!
I think that he did really well. I know that he's not going to like his place in this event. But you still have two more events, and he's done very well over the whole weekend.
So he's in fourth, 4 points out of third.
4 points out of third? All right.
One. This is arguably the greatest Game of Thrones / CrossFit fan poster ever made.
Who is this guy?
Thank you.
Hodor?
Yeah, why
he's
is
like
he hugging
this? The best character ever.
All right, I'll take it. It's awesome.
So we thought it would be funny to put Hobart's face on top of the character named Bran, and because his name is Hodor. So we thought like Hodor, Hobart, and apparently we thought he watches Game of Thrones, but he doesn't, so everyone else thought it was funny. I think he did too, so.
I'm gonna give you a hug. I really am. Thank you for being a fan.
Of course.
I think you knew that for the James Hobart Northeast Regional story,
yeah,
the piece,
purpose.
Yeah, you were like, ah, second place, sure, it would be good, but for the sake of the story, let's make it a little more dramatic, let's take it down a couple notches, fourth place, see what happens.
Not what I did, or would want to do, damn, yeah, I believe I can do it, I didn't come here to get fourth place, so. Doesn't happen overnight, you know, you gotta, takes years to cultivate a face like this. With a black eye.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How are we feeling today?
Ready to rock here, day three. Just FaceTime in Hobart.
Would really like it to go well. I'm not going out there to stay in fourth place, I'll tell you that 100%.
You expect to be on the podium at the end of the day?
Yeah.
How much would it mean to have Austin up there with you on the podium?
It'd be amazing to go back to the games with Austin. It'd be awesome. He, unfortunately, has a little more of a difficult circumstance. He's got a little more points to overcome. He'd have to have the people in second and third do poorly and him do well. That's never fun when you want to depend on that sort of thing. So we'll see how it turns out. CrossFit athletes, the laziest fit people on the planet.
Let me ask you a question that I ask a lot of athletes. And I get a lot of bullshit answers, so I want you to shoot me straight. Do you want to win the CrossFit Games?
Would I like to win the CrossFit Games? Yes. Do I want to win the CrossFit Games?
No. I want to qualify for the CrossFit Games. And the reason for that is just realistically, it's like, do I think I can go to the CrossFit Games and do well and stand among the other world-class athletes? Yes. But when I look at the people, the guys in the top five, and I compare myself to them, I don't think that's something I could do this year. And maybe this is a cash out, I don't know. And maybe it like makes me undeserving of a ticket to the games. But for me, I love competing in CrossFit. For me, I feel like it's a way for me to test myself constantly. It's, you know, something I absolutely enjoy doing. It's a way for me to, I feel like, give back to the community that supports me so much. But I think in order to be an athlete that's gonna go win the CrossFit Games, you have to make that your full-time job. And I think there are other things in my life I would wanna commit effort to make those my full-time job. For example, seminar staff. You know, for example, I wanna keep continuing to be a good friend to the people I'm friends with. I wanna develop as a coach. I really think in order to be someone who's at the top, you'd be willing to make sacrifices. Like, no matter what, I'm gonna go out and be the CrossFit Games champ. I'm gonna make every sacrifice possible to make that happen. Knowing that what it might take to achieve that goal, being realistic about what it might take to achieve that goal, I don't think I would wanna sacrifice everything in my life for that goal.
Did they say you did good?
Yeah, thank you.
You did good.
My level one T.
I love it.
The shirt I got at my level one that I took when I first went to a level one back in 2008. 2008. Maybe 2007. Maybe even 2009. Yeah, I don't know, special. I just had it a long time, it's cool. Straight up classic, just CrossFit. The fact that I still fit into it just tells me that I'm still a little weenie though.
What's it gonna be like seeing James on that podium? He's gonna be on the podium.
He's going to be on that podium. For me, it's like frosting on the cake. It's the best part of the whole thing because I'm so proud of him. I mean, even after yesterday, I'm so proud of what he does. And to watch these athletes work out in this sun and this heat, they're amazing. They're just so amazing. So I'm going to be over the top.
Regionals is sort of a different beast. There's always going to be somebody that you didn't know about, and sort of the nature of this competition, I mean, people are going to beat you at times. It could be your best friend, and I don't think that's going to change anything at all. I think that they'd be happy for each other. I mean, of course, upset about their own performance. I think they'd be more happy that it would be one of each other than somebody else.
He's a great athlete, and I think finally was able to couple his athleticism with training hard and getting his mind right at the right time. And, you know, I just want to support him. I mean, gosh, I mean, it's if there's someone to beat me, I'd like it to be him because he's my best buddy.
How does it feel to be going back to Carson as an individual?
In a single word, it's just absolutely amazing. I'm just very, very excited, humbled so much. I've really had an awesome year training. I've had an enormous support from just friends, family, colleagues, as far as like, hey, you can do it, believe in you. I can't say enough good about that. So very, very lucky, 1,000% happy. Well, now, good thing I didn't buy you that ticket. Because you wouldn't have gone. Thank you so much.
You're a level one staff member of mine. Oh, so, yeah.
Awesome. Where?
I was in CrossFit King of Prussia.
Okay.
It was last April or something like that.
Awesome.
But yeah, so I was really.
Thank you so
weekend.
Much for hanging out with us. Yeah, I appreciate that a lot.
Wow. You're great, man.
Nice to meet you. You went fast enough
too. Appreciate it.
Your second place finisher this weekend, hailing from CrossFit New England, James Hobart.
Congrats, guys. Thanks, buddy. Any help?
job.
You good job. Did it.
Look at you, proven. All over, top to bottom.
Sad, buddy.
Why?
Because I don't get to go to the games with you.
Well?
I know you're sad, too.
Well, now you gotta, now. I'm sure we'll be running a lot together over the next month.
Yeah, I just ran over here and I was out of breath, so.
I was so happy Dave noticed the shirt. Castro sent me a text, congrats. I like the shirt, nice touch. That was my only goal.
So it's like I said earlier, there's more than meets the eye with James Hobart. I only spent a few days with him, but by the time I left, we'd become friends. He let me crash on his couch, he let me raid his fridge. His home was my home. That's just the type of person he is. He cares more about his family and friends than he does himself, and he wouldn't give any of it up, even if it meant a shot at winning the CrossFit Games.